Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn about creating power apps in Microsoft Teams with Dataverse for Teams. So Dataverse for Teams was formerly known as Project Oakdale. It was the code name that they were using, and Dataverse was formerly known as Common Data Service. So Common Data Service works as a backbone for the overall Power Platform, where they can store data and information, where they can create tables, columns, so define the overall model of the Power Apps in the Common Data Service, which is now called Dataverse. While Dataverse for Teams support as a platform or an environment where they can create bots, apps, and Power Automate to automate workflows. So by definition, with Dataverse for Teams, you will get all the Power Platform, that is Power Apps, Power Automate, Virtual Agents within Microsoft Teams. That means you can create apps within Teams, create bots within Teams, and automate workflows. In terms of licensing, you have pretty much, if you have a Teams license, you get it all. So you don't have to pay for anything else. If you have a basic Teams license, you get the Dataverse for Teams with it. So even without Dataverse for Teams, you might be wondering that you were still able to create apps before, right? But the thing here is with Microsoft Teams Toolkit, which you can use for Visual Studio or VS Code, it's very difficult to build apps. So in terms of return of investment of building apps in Teams, it's very high compared to what you can do with Dataverse for Teams in Power in Teams. So Power Platform makes it lots easier and faster. So what do you get? With each Teams theme, so when you create a Teams in within a team, you get a separate Dataverse for Teams environment. And if the team is deleted, the Dataverse for Team environment that was created for that team is deleted. Apart from that, you get a 2 GB storage capacity for each Dataverse for Teams environment, and you can have up to 1 million records in each environment. And in terms of security, it's OMZ. So owners, members, and guests within the team can access your apps as well as the data in your teams. So what if everybody starts to create apps and my Teams becomes a Power Apps app coverage? So in that case, we can use Center of Excellence toolkit, where you can govern the creation of apps or creation of Dataverse environment within Teams that will help you as an IT administrator to govern the overall Teams environment within Dataverse for Teams environment. So if you run out of 2 GB space, then you can convert Dataverse for Teams into Dataverse, which is much bigger and has more capacity. I think it's 4 TB of capacity that you get within the Dataverse. So I have my Teams here. So first of all, I'll create a team from scratch. So now that my team is created, I can add members to it. For this demo, let's not add anyone. So I have my team, I have my channel. You can add further channels to this team. Now after this is done, you can go to this ellipsis and search for Power Apps. And you can add the Power Apps to your team. So usually when you close and open this theme, this Power Apps will disappear. So what you can do is you can right click here and pin this so that it will stay here. So now you can create an app on in Teams. You can click create an app. There are a couple of sample apps there. So you can use employee ideas, inspection, issue reporting apps that has already been built over here, which you can use. So I'll create an app from scratch. So I'll just create it here. So now I would select the team this app is going to be added. This is my team. Create. So now on the backside of our environment, what it is doing is it's creating all the artifacts that is required for this team. So if you go to your admin center and check a new environment with the environment type Microsoft Teams will be created. So we are getting a new Dataverse environment being created when we create a app for our teams and in Teams. So my environment has been created, and you will also get a notification, something like this. So you also get a notification in your feed. So here I go again, go to build. So now I can go to new and create an app or a chatbot. You can also create flows and tables for that. So I'll first start with creating an app. So let's call my app work from home request app. Now that this app is created, we need a table where all our work from home request is stored. So now once this is created, I create a new table and create a new table called WFH request. So this is the place where all our request data is stored. So I create, and now I can add, so this is a table. So now I can add columns to it. Let's call my first column as reasons. So there can be a date. So there are different types of columns that you can add. It can be a table, email, URL, phone, auto number, number, date. So whatever field type that you want to create, it can be created. I will put a field called date. Make it date. So I have a reason, I have a date. So I need to tell what are the tasks. So these are the tasks that I'm gonna do. If you check the advanced option, you can increase the maximum length. I can define my availability. Reason is done, date, task, availability. And at the end of the day, you will probably write a report of the work that you have done. Puts its max length as 1000 again, and then maybe approval status. So approval status can be pending. So once pending is approved, your report is pending. So report pending and approved. So for pending, it will turn to report pending, then approved. So I can enter data directly from here as well. This is pretty have a good UI where you can enter data directly from here. COVID-19, so that's why I'm working from home. I can select a date, so let's say today. Create a WFH app all day I'm available. except for afternoon 1 to 2 report not needed, and status would be pending. So close it. So now this would automatically generate an app for you, which looks something like this. And this is the app that you can create from blank as well. If you don't like the layout of this app, you can just create a new screen from blank. And using the conventional power apps method, you can add galleries, you can add, and then you can associate it with a table. Then you can add forms like this. And then again, you can associate it with the table. So you can use the conventional Power Apps app development methodology to create this app as well. But in this case, since I already have it here, I'll just use this one. So I can also change the layout from here. I would love like something like this. So this is the app that has been generated. You can put logics to it. Let's say when the form is new, you might not want this to be displayed. So maybe name of the form is edit form. If edit to so I might just want the report to be displayed when it's edited and not when it's new. So when it's new, it's not showing, but when it's being edited, it'll show up. So simple logic like these can be applied to it. And the overall pending and pending from approval can be done using flows. So I'll just publish this app. And when you publish this app, it will ask you where do you want this app to be published to. So it will ask you the channel. So I have just one channel here. So if I add it here and save and close, so this app would be displayed into the general channel, and you, the members of that channel, the guests of the channel or the owners of the channel can use this app. So if I go here and check here, I have an app ready to be used. So you can use this app for your WFH approval or employee onboarding, or different ways you can use this app, or you can create new apps that can be used within your environment so that your users does not have to go to many places. The Teams can be a center, a one-point solution for your overall process in your organizations. That's how you can use this app. And just not the app, there are lots of things that you can do. You can create flows, you can create bots. As I've mentioned in the next tutorial, I will create an approval flow for this WFH request, so that when this WFH app is used, a request is sent out to the supervisor, and the supervisor would be able to approve the request. So that's gonna be it for this video. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please subscribe and click the bell notification to be aware of more videos like this. In the next video or the continuation of this one, I'll be creating a flow within Dataverse for Teams, and I will also create a video on creating bots on Teams. So wait for those videos. Until then, please like and subscribe. Thanks so much.